Hey, horse and gun people. So I'm putting on this motion light. These are pretty bright. They're freaking great. Lights up all out here if somebody walks on my patio. So I'm putting it up, and you can tell where the old one was. You know, there's a lot of cocks. So I got to paint it and cock it. But if you look back here, there's not enough room in this little bitty plate here to go on the wall. Now, why is that? Because when they built the house or whoever added these wires, they just put the two wires through. No ground, I might add. Oh, maybe there is a ground. There is a ground there. So they put the two wires through, and there's just a metal piece. So there's just a hole in this concrete siding. And I looked everywhere for a video how to do this. So I'm going to show you how I'm fixing this problem in order to mount a light, because these flat little pieces won't allow you to mount it. There's not enough space when you buy a light for all these. And I think it's called a junction box or a round junction box. Hi, Monkey Cat. Come to help Dad? All right, let's get to it. So here's my fix without drilling. They got these boxes here. I don't know what it's called. Commercial electric. Anyway, it's got four holes so you can run conduit, and it's got one in the back. Comes with the little four screw caps. You put those in, makes it a good solid box. Got a ground screw. That hole right there is where I'm going to put the wires through, and then I'm going to attach the light on top of this, and I'll put these two here. So it will go on here. It's going to extend the light out a little bit, so the light will hold it, and I don't have to drill in and recess a box and worry about hitting wires. And you know, if I start coming in here, I don't know where there's a stud, where the wire is coming at. If I have to dig a big hole in order to get a box recessed, it would be a pain. This is in a corner. It's not going to do anything. I'm not worried about it. This little box right here is going to extend this out that far, which is probably better because it's so close to the wall here. I'm losing some light right here. So this is going to extend it out, and I will put that right there. Wires will come out, and that's what it'll look like. Pull the light off. Got this. I had to put this out so I could get a little grabbing on it last time. Actually, I think it should go the other way, but I had to put it this way to try to give me a little room back there. I'm pretty sure I turned this off. This is on a switch. If your electricity isn't off, you can just kind of lick your fingers there and then just grab the black wire like that. And if you don't get a shock, you know it's off. That's for those guys that can't afford the fancy tools. Hey, look what I found tucked back there. That's where the little ground wire went. I thought it didn't have a ground wire. He just tucked it back there. Ah, we don't need that. I'll pull that out and ground the box. So this little latch here can either go here, if I wanted to adjust it, or here. Pretty good design box. My ground wire is right back there. I'm going to put that ground wire on there, probably run a thing off and ground my other thing also. Okay, so I just put a bead of caulk around there, put a little caulk back in there to kind of help for the wind and the seal. My wires are out. I also put a bead around back here so when I push this onto the wall, it's going to seal. So I'll get these wires through here. And then I'll hang that up and seal that. Screw it on. Okay, put a screw here. Screw here. I'm mounting. Light's gonna go over that. Do my wiring. Should be good to go. A lot better. Less airflow. Put some caulk in there and around the inside of this beam here. Let me get my wiring, hook up my light. Trying to hold and wire these without dropping a light. I just got a little piece of hay string, tied a little loop, hooked that on there. That way I can wire my light without worrying about the wires getting pulled off, put my ground in, and then I'll set it up there. Don't forget your gasket before you do your wiring, or you're going to have to, if you do forget it, you can just cut your gasket and put it around afterwards. Not the end of the world, but anyway, this is up. I put some caulk behind it. If I wanted to, I could put another bead of caulk here. I may or may not do that, but let's get the wiring done. Here's where I screwed up, my stupid wires. So you notice my black wire I put under this so I could connect it so all my wires would be behind this. However, on a white wire, I forgot to run it behind it. So now one's on top and the other one's on top. So now when I try to bend it, this wire is going to be over this. So I have to undo this, run this behind it so they're both on the same side of this. I could probably take this off and reapply this instead of unwiring it. Either way, half does the other. Okay, wiring's done. White's there. Black's so much easier to work when you have a room and you're not trying to shove all these wires in here. So I still have to get these little wire clips down the bottom here. Got my gasket on and seal it up, put my center screw in, should be good to go. And we have liftoff. So this is on a light switch. So when I turn a light switch on, a light works. So if I ever want to turn this off and I don't want it working, I can turn the light switch off. There's still a little plug that's right there on the ground that I need to put in that hole right there. I did put a little caulk around here, just spread a little bit of line there, even though I had some behind it. But it's up and running, and that's how you install that. Now I'm gonna go up the front and put one up there. So I took this light off, which was extremely full of bugs and everything because it wasn't caulked before I got here. I caulked it when I got here. So before that was caulked, the whole thing was just full of dirt, daubers, and stuff. So that needed to be pulled off and cleaned anyway. Now I'm going to pull that off. I'm going to put this up here, and I'm going to have me one also on a switch with a... this isn't going to be a motion detector. This will just be a switch, but I'm going to have a nice, you know, 3,000 lumen light up here. So when I turn this on, I can see. All right, so these little box that I think worked. Obviously, you can cut a hole, you can recess it, and get the regular box. I don't like start cutting because this place, you don't know where the wire is and everything at. I mean, you could. It's not. Some people will say that's better. This is easy. This is cheap. This is whatever. I just wanted to share it because I couldn't find one video on a solution to fixing this to where you can mount a new LED light. And so now I did it, and we're done. Y'all have a good one.